What's up, everyone, and welcome to Ola Testing Out Gear 10 years later. Hiya! You know what? I've been running my channel for more than 10 f***ing years. How about that? And when I started my YouTube channel, I was doing amplifier tests only, without any talking, just playing songs and whatnot. And, you know, I borrowed amplifiers and whatnot, and then I turned them back to their owners. So a lot of people have asked, like, you should revisit this and this amplifier, but I haven't had the opportunity to find one. Anyways, today I'm trying out one of my most popular first amplifier. The Framus Cobra is back in the house, y'all. How about this? The Framus Cobras, and there's also another amplifier called Dragon, they're not being made anymore, so these are not as easy to come by as they were back in the past, and maybe a little bit of an underdog when it comes to metal amplifiers. When I talk about it with people don't seem to know of the amplifier at all. But I managed to get a hold of one. It came with a weird sound. I switched out the power amp tubes to Tungsoul EL34s, and now it sounds okay. I'm also using the same guitar, my Ibanez MTM2, like I did in the original video. However, this time it has a Seymour Duncan Dimebucker in it, so there's a little bit of difference there. And there's also a difference with the cabinet. In my first initial video, I was using a Roadster 2x12 Mesa cabinet with vintage 30s. This is a matching Framus Cobra cabinet right here, loaded with Celestian Greenbacks. Now, this cabinet has a little bit of history to it, because this was the cabinet that was used on the Haunted album One Kill Wonder, which is an excellent album, by the way. So I borrowed it from the other guitar player, and here it is, and it's all matching glory like this. I also have a Tube Screamer that I will engage later in the video, but let's just start off with some basic tones, okay? Let's go. We're on the crunch channel right now, the middle one. Let's just f***ing do it. That's pretty f***ing chunky, man. I like this tone. It's working in all the frequencies and so thick. I'm gonna check this out. So right now, there's also a notch mode, which will make it even more mid-scoop. Check this out. Very mid-scooped, and you know, almost non-usable, but if you turn up the mids... still unusable, in my opinion. So, let's turn that off. I just cannot get enough of that chug right now. F***ing hell. Okay, let's go to the lead channel, which has a lot more gain. We have gain at like 11 o'clock right now. Let's go max. Gets very flubby and muddy, but going back. There's almost too much gain, man. Okay, even more. shit, man. Okay, let's go engage a tube screamer, just as a test. Dialing down the gain a little bit. I made a mistake. The tube screamer was on. So now it's without the tube screamer, okay? Still incredibly thick, man. Okay, let's go back to the lead channel and check it out and see how it is without the tube screamer, okay? It's good, man. I like it. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me a little bit of a diesel amplifier in the bass range, like how it compresses the bass. Play clean a little bit. Oh, a little out of tune, that's okay. There it is. That's a nice little dynamic push right there. I don't think, when I installed this pickup, I think I bypassed this pickup, so I can't show you any cool, you know, split modes or anything like that. All right, back to crunch. I think I have to try it with a solar guitar, just, you know, for reference, because I'm so used to Duncan Solar, okay? Let's try this. Oh, that was a neck pickup, okay? Holy shit. You can definitely hear the Duncan Solar has a lot less output when it comes to the pickup, but it's very dynamic and has a better, in my opinion, a little better push, but the Dimebucker, obviously, it's more for high gain and fucking, you know, dimebagging shit all over. So there you go, man. That's the Framus Cobra for you right there. 10 years later. I think it sounds fucking excellent. I mean, it's such a thick tone on this gain character right here. It's just so bassy. Has a little bit of that gnarly compression in the low end, which like, just makes it a little tasty. Let's just say that. I got hair in my mouth. Anyways. I hope you enjoyed this little video. If you did not, I'm sorry. If you did, maybe you can request what to do for next video 10 years later. How about that? Thank you so much for watching, guys, and hope you have a good day. Bye.